Hi everyone and welcome back to this series of PAO exam, Electrical B7 Power Systems Engineering. And this is another question about the symmetrical faults. We had one question before about the symmetrical faults where you have the fault happening at the bus. Here, the fault happened at the middle of the line 1 to 3. So between 1 to 3, we have the fault happened here. So it's a bit different than the previous one. This question coming from a bit older exam, but the idea is, because it's different than the other one, I thought it's interesting to share it with you. Okay, so let's see the question here clearly. It says here, this is the single line diagram that we have here. And we assume that the voltage is, as usual, is 1 per unit here. And the fault happened here. The fault happened at the middle of this line. So we will draw the reactance diagram, okay? And we will short circuit all voltage sources, and we'll have one common ground. So basically here, this is the ground, common ground, okay? Now this is bus one, which corresponds to this bus. Now the generator is connected to the ground, so it will be short circuited, and this is the impedance of the generator, which is J.2, okay. And then we will have the between 1 to 4 and 4 to 3. These two are in series. And the reason, because this bus is not connected to a load or not connected to a generator. So it's not attached to the ground and there is no fault here. So these two points are basically connected in series. So to make things clearer and easier to visualize, I will put these two lines on top of this because it's in parallel. This is between bus one and bus three. So this is bus number three. Okay, so we will have here this, and then we will have here to bus number four. So we will have the J.215, and then we will have the J.125. So I just flipped it, that's all. And then between 1 and 3, we will have the line. In the middle, we have the fault. So the fault will split the line into two pieces with equal impedance, because the fault happened in the middle. So from here and here, and this is 0.225. So each one will have half of this, which is basically will be J.1125, J.1125. Now, bus three is going to bus number two through this transformer impedance, which is J.035. And then finally, the generator is connected to the same ground here with J.15. This is bus number two, okay? And this is the common ground. And now I want to find the impedance or the total reactance X Thevenin between these two points. So that is the overall circuit that we are interested in. So as I said, these two will be in series. So I will connect them in series. And these two also, they are in series. I will connect them. So this will be add these two, J.34. And then we will have the fault point, J.1125, J.1125. And then we will have here these two in series, J.18. And this is J.2, and I am looking between these two, and this is my X 7. So now this is a delta configuration. I want to change this into Y. So let me just pick up a different color here. So here we will have a Y connection here, like this, like this. So this I will call it XA, XB, and XC. So your XA is equal to the multiplication of these two adjacent reactances to XA divided by the summation of all of them. So it is J.34 times J.1125 divided by J.35 plus 0.4 plus J.1125 plus J.1125. So all of this will be J.565, and this will give me a J of 0.0677. Now clearly also XB is exact, this is equal to XP, because XP exactly the same. Finally, my XC will equal to J.1125 times J.1125 divided by the summation of the three, which is the J.565, and this will give me a total reactance of J.0224. So we found the three reactants. Now I will redraw the circuit, but I will remove this, this, and this, and I will have the corresponding Y connection. So we basically, we will have here, this is the J.0677 in series with the J.2. Now I will have here the J.0224, and again here the J.0677 in series with the J.18. So basically what I have done, I took XA, XB, and C here and connect them and removed the delta connection. We get up this. Now this with this in series, this with this in series. So let's do it step by step here. Basically we will have this with this in series. We will have J.2677. J.0224, and this is the last one here connected to this, and then here of course this is your X7. This is open, this is not closed, and this is equal to basically J.2477. Now what is the total X7 now? It will be basically this and this in parallel, J.2677. This is in parallel with J.2477, and everything in series plus with the J.0224. And if you do that, you'll find that the total reactance is J.153. So once we know X7, my fault current, I fault. Now we use the pre voltages before the fault, which is the 1 per unit. So 1 angle of 0 divided by J.153. And this will give me minus J6.54. So that is my fault current. Now, the question is, here says, find the voltages at bus number 1 and bus number 2 under these fault conditions. So basically here, the voltage is here is equal to 1 per unit at the generator. Now, when we have the fault, we have here I coming from G1, and the voltage at bus 1 will be the 1 per unit minus the current IG1 times the J.2. There is a voltage drop happening here, and this is the voltage at the bus number one. Bus number two, the same thing, exactly the same thing. So I need to find IG1 and IG2. How much each generator contributing to this fault current? So we will go to the last diagram that we have here. And we have these, basically, this is my fault current happening here. Okay, and this is coming from IG1, and here coming from IG2. This is J.2677, J.2477, and here I have my fault current, okay, which is I just calculate, which is the minus J.6.54. Okay, so how much coming from IG1, how much coming from IG2? This is very simple current division. So your IG1 is coming equal to the main current minus J6.54 times the other impedance, J.2477, divided by the summation of the two impedances in parallel, the J.2477 plus the J.2677, and this will give me minus J3.14, and your IG2 is equal to the main current minus this current, basically, okay, or you can apply again the current division, so it is minus J6.54 minus J3.14, and this will give me minus J3.4. So I know now how much current coming from IG1, how much current is coming from IG2. So the voltage at bus 1 is equal to 1 minus the current, which is the minus J3.14 times the J of the 0.2, the impedance of the generator. And this will give me a voltage equal at bus number one, equal to 0.37 per unit. And the voltage at bus two will equal to 1 minus the current, the minus J3.4 times the impedance, the J.15. And this will give me 0.49 per unit. I have seen a different way of approaching this by finding the Z bus matrix, which is different than the bus admittance matrix, but I found this is a much easier solution to find your value of the fault current and the contribution from each generator, and also what is the voltages at each bus.